I think we're into episode 3. Going into deep 6. Okay. Hold the phone. Don't keep it. Okay, one sec. Here we go. This is better. Backstabbing bastard.
I felt thin as death. I've been living on an endless supply of weak old donuts.
Yeah, that's why you never.
They were fuel for this crazy furnace inside my head. I couldn't remember when I had last seen the sun. I was on a permanent graveyard shift. When the darkness fell, New York City became something else. Any old Sinatra song notwithstanding. Bad things happened in the night on the streets of that other city. Noir York City. After a cup of coffee that tasted like engine oil, when a new message from BB got me back on the killer track.
What the hell happened at Roscoe Street? Maxie, I'm going out on a limb here. We need to talk this through, come up with a plan. 2:30 a.m., the Choir Communications Garage.
The more I thought about Alex's murder and the frame-up, the more it felt like an inside job. I should have seen it coming. BB had sold me out, and now he wanted to finish what he'd started. The garage was dead. BB showed up in his tailor-made suit, gold watch, and cufflinks to match. All way beyond a cop's pay.
Maxie.
Losing suave charm, he was guilty as hell. What the hell does BB stand for anyway? Backstabbing bastard.
Come on, don't be like that. Have a cigar.
I don't smoke.
Maxie, you have no idea how big this is. It's huge. You have no idea.
I think I do. You're a bribe-taking bent cop who sold out his partner. Those mobsters in the subway were a dead giveaway. Hard to miss. Bet it was exactly like this with Alex. Up close and personal.
You can't win this one, Max.
No, but I can make damn sure none of you do either. BB turned out to be another cardboard cutout bad guy.
Thank you. Christmas. Good night. Do you remember that? Oh, cool. It's a girl, but... Ooh, you missed me there. That's a good thing I did say.
X-Files.
You have seen the files on Project Valhalla. We can fill the gap.
all involved in the early stages of the project during the Gulf War.
What's the catch?
We would very much like to blow this thing wide open, but our hands are tied.
Nice.
Her name is Nicole Horn. She was the key figure in Project Valhalla. When the funding was discontinued, she simply refused to quit. She knew exactly what she had in her hands. Nicole Horn is the president of Acer Corporation. She has more than half the city in her pocket. This must be kept under wraps. If you try to go public with this, we will deny any knowledge. We need you to take her out. Afterwards, we can protect you. Make all the charges go away.
I see.
That was the cue for the killer suits to kick in the doors and swarm inside.
Yep.
Alfred Woden stood up, miraculously waking from his dirt nap, looking smug among his dead pals. In the land of the blind, the one-eyed man is king. I didn't know how he pulled it off, but it was a pretty slick way to get out of all his promises. Most of what he had said fit too well to be a load of crap.
Walked in your own fire. Lovely. Roger. I was dead.
Woden's office was at the top of the building, right below her penthouse suite. The elevators were controlled by a security computer, part of the mainframe located underground below the building. The high-rise was sealed as tight as a sci-fi fortress.
Bye. Come on. Okay. Philip, and I'm not. Bison power game.
That dream of revenge. Those dreams were always nightmares of coming close and then failing. Now I was close. I had a name to guide me. The call horn. I had nothing to lose.
Also didn't have anything in the game either. Okay. I'm gonna leave this episode here. As Max said, we now have a name and we are on 6. So it looks like we only have one episode left. Because I believe. Let's take this first. Just to make sure. Nope, sorry. That's chapter 6. Really? I can't exit. Three more chapters. Queen says there's 3. So I might just include that all into one big episode to finish it out. The Android Gamer, Larry Dave, and happy gaming!